Hi guys. So today is on what today is?
Welcome back to my channel. My name is Masimbuthia. In case you're new here, I make videos about motherhood and anything else that revolves around us. So today I want to share with you my labor and delivery story. And before I do that, please make sure you subscribe to my channel. I'm waiting for you to subscribe. Okay, so it began on the 21st of October, around 10. I felt some tightening in my stomach, but it wasn't painful. And at first I thought it is the baby stretching, but I realized it was quite different. Then since I was already 40 weeks and 3 days, I was like, probably this is the baby coming, but let me just take my time and observe and see what happens. So at around 3, I lost my mucus plug. I lost my mucus plug at around 3, and I had some bloody show. So I decided to go to the hospital because it was quite a distance, and I realized, since I don't know my history, and I was praying for a Hebrew bath that would take 30 minutes, said, let me just go and get checked, and if they just tell me to go back home, it's okay. Guy, what happened?
So guys, here we are after how many hours so far?
6 hours.
6 hours of labor. Hey everyone. So now it's about 4:20. Gosh, I've been in this for now 9 straight hours. The last time I checked, I was I was checked, I was at 6 centimeters, and it's now becoming almost, it is so, the surges are so strong. Oh God, and I'm just praying for this to be over soon. I've realized my body has started to sort of, I don't know, react differently to pain, especially when I'm being examined vaginally, the VE. I'm also shaky all over. I can't relax. I can't do anything, and I am just so shaky. I don't know how I'm going to face the next one because they still have to check again, but I'm still hoping for the best, and I am feeling so exhausted, but all will be well.
At around 6 in the morning, they did the normal check, and at this point I was 7 centimeters dilated, but they did some intervention. The nurse did perform cervical swab, which apparently was to help to increase the contractions, and also they broke my water, which was these two exercises were so painful, and they gave me Buscopan. I don't know for what reason. So at this point I was just praying that, whoa, I want this process to be over. But all along it had not been like super painful the way I was thinking. In fact, at some point from 5 to 6 the pains disappeared and I slept. So I just went back to my normal walking and dancing and seeing whether the baby would come. And at 7:30, they induced me using a drip to make the contractions stronger and, you know, close together, which would help to bring the baby, you know. Then they said, at this point, I'd already labored for about maybe 20 hours actually. So they said by 10 we are going to give you up to 10:30. By 10:30 you should have already given birth, or you should be giving birth, because now at this point it was 7 centimeters. Yeah, so I just went. Now the pains became intense. 10:30. I was checked again before any other action could be taken, and I was 8 centimeters at this point. The nurse also realized that my baby had not engaged, so she said even if I get to 10 centimeters, there's no way I was going to give birth naturally. So I was booked for an emergency C-section, and so they just disconnected the drip. And they put some water, and was told not to take anything, not to drink anything. And they just went to prepare. As I went back to the labor ward, just to wait to be called to go to the theater. I was checked again before any other action could be taken, and I was 8 centimeters at this point. The nurse also realized that my baby had not engaged, so she said even if I get to 10 centimeters, there's no way I was going to give birth naturally. So I was booked for an emergency C-section, and so they just disconnected the drip, and they put some water, and was told not to take anything, not to drink anything. And they just went to prepare. As I went back to the labor ward, just to wait to be called to go to the... It took them an hour to prepare. So I went to theater at 11:30. And at this time, now the pains had... the surges had become less stronger. And as I was walking to theater, I was just complaining to the nurse and saying, I wish I wish I knew. We could have just gone to the theater direct. And he was like, no, you know, it's that laboring process has really helped you and your body to know that a baby is coming, so you will not struggle to get milk, which actually turned out to be true. I got milk immediately after theater. So I went to the theater. The doctor, that word is so hard. The doctor is responsible to give you anesthesia. Yes, that one. So he was the only man in the room. So I thought he was the doctor. He was the one to perform the surgery. So I asked him, when do you want to try to angle? And he was like, no, I'm just responsible to make sure you don't feel any pain. And at this point, I had felt so much pain, and each intervention they were doing wasn't working. So I was so mad, and I knew, you're just saying that, you know, I'm going to feel pain. And so he injected me with the local anesthesia. And before the surgery, the doctor was to perform the surgery came. She was she came, she prayed before they started the surgery, and she began. The moment she did the first incision, I felt some pain. I told the other doctor responsible for the anus, whatever. I told him, I'm feeling pain. He told me, no, your blood pressure is quite low. You should not feel any pain. So I was like, okay. I'm not sure what I'm feeling then. They did another incision. And the reason why I know what they were doing is because I had watched so many cesarean births. Although when I was watching, I was like, oh, this is not me. I'm going to have my baby normally, so I'm just watching. So at this point, they had already inserted like the curtain, so I can't see what they're doing. But in my mind, I know what they are doing. And when they did now the other incision, it was so painful, I screamed. And the other doctor said, Pume, you're really feeling pain. I told him, yes. So he pinched my ears. And the other doc did something around there, and he asked, which is painful? I told him both. Then he was like, well, if you're feeling pain, we can't allow you to feel pain. I'm going to give you another drug, or you're going to be knocked out, and your blood pressure is going to be even lower. At this moment, I didn't even care what that meant. I was just like, do whatever you have to do. But in my mind, I was like, I know it's not going to work. Nothing is working. So he injected me the other drug, and he told me to count up to 30. Now I was so determined, I was so sure I was going to get to 30. So he started counting together, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then I was out. At 7, I was gone. So they finished the surgery. I didn't feel anything. I didn't even know myself. So they finished the surgery. The moment now I regained consciousness was I was being wheeled, I think, out of the theater, if I'm not wrong. But I wasn't yet conscious vizuri. So I could see the curtains of the hospital were like yellow, goldenish, I think. I don't know that color. So in my mind, for a moment, I thought, oh my God, I'm in heaven. Then I realized, no, I'm being pushed. So I think I'm still in the hospital. Then it hit me, okay. Then they lifted me now, transferring me to now the ward bed. And that moment, I felt sharp pain around the incision area. That's when I realized, I remember now, oh, I had come to give birth, and I asked, where is my baby? And all this time, my baby was there being held by the dad, my hubby, and I was so happy to see him. He was so calm. He was just there wandering. He had opened his eyes, but he wasn't crying. So he was just looking around, and I think he was wondering, where the hell am I? So I just looked at him. I tried to breastfeed, but my whole body was so heavy. I slept like nothing. I just went off. Yeah, but that generally was my story. It was such a beautiful birth, and as much as things didn't really happen how I expect them to or I had planned, I am so thankful to God because both of us are okay, my baby and I, and it was such a beautiful, beautiful experience. So the only thing I feel that I missed was the first cry. I mean, I didn't hear my baby cry until the next day, and I felt bad because of that, but basically everything else was just perfect. So if you are expecting, I wish you all the best. And by the way, if you've reached to the end of this video, please subscribe, support this channel by subscribing. It's just free of charge. And be on the lookout for my next video. It will be a continuation, or rather like what you feel, or how, what I felt after my C-section, the healing process. Yeah, and that's it. See you in the next video.